how important is it to be sitting here at 1-1 instead of 0-2? Just mentality.
Yeah, I would agree with the a win is a win. You know, there's always things to look at and say, basketball-wise, you know, okay, we got to work on this, we got to work on that. Sometimes you can do that after a loss. Sometimes you do it after a close win, an overtime, a blowout win. But I think at the end of the day right now, we're in conference, and conference is about winning games. The improvement is really something that you want to get throughout the season and significantly, obviously, in the non-conference. But in conference, it's you're playing for something. You're playing for one of your goals, which is to win a regular season and then a tournament as well. So now it's results. You got to get results. And we got the right result. Maybe it wasn't pretty, but it was the right result.
And moving on to Utah State, I mean, they got some pretty big guards. I think their three leading scorers are above 6'5 guards.
Yeah, they've got good size. Yeah, they got really good size. San Jose State was the third tallest team in the country as well. So we're going to see it throughout conference now. And I think having the style of play in that we're comfortable playing against, and we've seen, you know, for several years, even when I was at New Mexico State. So we have a pretty good plan of attack. Now the players got to go out and execute it. So I think regardless of, you know, what they have from a length perspective, you're going to get that on different nights. So I think it's more about how the guys will match up against their guys.
What is it about Kobe McKeown that stands out to you the most?
Say it one more time.
Kobe McKeown, what stands out to you the most?
Oh, just his toughness and versatility. He can shoot it, bounce it. Really good passer as well. He's just got a lot of attributes that make up a good basketball player. And he's still very young, and so he's gonna give them, you know, three good years. I think 2.5 good years left of basketball. So, but he does so many things well. I think it's something that it's always tough to guard guys that can both shoot it well and put it on the deck well, because you can't just jam them on the 3-point line because they can bounce it as well too. So you gotta be an elite defender to guard guys like that, and you gotta do it by committee.
How important is Travell Beck's play been off the bench? I think he had 9 points in 10 minutes against San Jose State.
He can get buckets. Just that's one thing he can do. You know, Travell has been a good spark for us. What a great attitude. You know, guys like that who could probably play some more minutes at another university, but are still engaged in the process of development, staying humble, staying hungry, being a great teammate, I think is what stands out for us. So we need his play. We need his continued mindset, as well as Mbake's and anybody else that comes off the bench. Check in the rest of the guys. They stay engaged with team and put the team's mission above their own. I think we're gonna be successful going forward.
Brandon McCoy, he's a leading scorer. He's been offensively pretty consistent. Defensively, what have you seen from him? Where do you think he stands right now?
Well, I've seen a freshman, you know, who's learning how to play at another level that he's used to, and he's developing. You know, he's still figuring out some things that I think all bigs across the country are, whether they're, listen, I'm still developing, I'm still growing, I'm still trying to become a better coach at 56. So it's just a process, and it's about embracing it and wanting the coaching and the development, which he does, which is why, you know, we're so excited to have him there, because he's invested. I've said that several times, but defensively, I don't think you know, it's any different than any other freshman in terms of really just getting better as the season goes on, and hopefully he's playing his best basketball, and we're playing our best basketball when we get to crunch time.
Remember a couple of weeks ago you said you wanted him to do his work earlier defensively.
Yeah, defensively.
Well, can you sort of just expound on that, uh-huh, and what that means for?
Sure, it's stances and engagement, and you know, it's your posture. It's not, you know, getting low isn't bending at the waist. Getting low is bending at the knees. It's being in the right position on the floor before the contact and before you even engage in the post. Offensively, you know, there's development there. Defensively, there's a development to be had there as well. So it's on both sides of the basketball, and I continue to see his body changing since he got here physically. You know, he's doing better things with nutrition. He's doing, you know, he's just growing in a lot of different areas. And so defensively, I think to be more to the point, I think, defensively, doing his work early is described as being more engaged early, so he doesn't get caught, you know, standing dead behind guys. And he's still working on that. We're showing him film, and he's getting better.
How do you coach him, or what do you tell him in terms of leaving his man to go help side, contest a shot, try to block a shot? When's the right time to leave?
Well, that's a long answer, because there's a lot of different scenarios. Are we in man? Are we in zone? Or who are you leaving? Who are you, you know what I'm saying? It's kind of, it can get very technical. I would just tell you, you know, the main thing is, again, like Mike alluded to, if you are in the right defensive position and you leave to help someone else, and your placement, foot placement is correct, and that pass goes back to your guy, then you're able to get back. It's when you turn and you get square and you're committed to the help, and that's not the specific game plan. Now, sometimes we're going over to take like a baseline drive, and then your foot placement is different than if you're just in staying in basic man-to-man and the guy's being guarded still. So that's probably a coaching clinic I can give you later on that. But it's not that simple, you know what I mean?
After rewatching San Jose State game, what were the issues you saw with entry passes?
I think our posts were, we use the term possession over position, where you want to gain that possession of the ball over giving up position. So if you have to give up position to make sure we gain possession, we had a lot of the bigs were kind of, you know, not ready to catch it. We showed some film with Mbake and Shakur and Brandon as well, where they weren't doing a good job of holding their seal, and they go in to retrieve the ball, almost rebounding the ball out of the air on the pass. A lot has to do with how they frame up and have their defensive balance and positioning. So, I mean, offensive balance and positioning. So I think we were able to make some constructive criticisms there that I think the guys really understood once you slowed it down and showed them. So, because the guards are doing what they're supposed to do, you know, speed them when they're open. But it's a big responsibility to stay open and catch it.
Are you still anticipating getting Anthony and Chuck back tomorrow?
Yep, I'm expecting both those guys to be good to go. This guy got a, I haven't talked to him today yet about physical condition, but I think Chuck's good to go already. I know for sure. I haven't talked to Anthony yet about, or Brian Lindell about his ankle, but the other guys are good to go.
Did you get a chance to talk to Jovan Mooring about, you know, his shooting? Or
talk
did
to
you
him
get
every day. I talk to him every day. You know, again, there's, there is a way to play this game of basketball that I want the guys to play, and they will play. And they're constantly learning how I want to play and how I coach and what our system is. So Javon's been here a year and, 15 games? So he's still in the process of figuring out, as a head coach, what I want him to do. And he's growing and getting better, you know? So, yeah, we talk all the time and we watch film. We sat and watched some clips yesterday before practice on specifics offensively of what's a good possession look like. Where he may have passed up some shots that came inside out to him. And he goes, yeah, I see that now. And so, you know, it's just like classroom. You gotta go to class, gotta attend class to get educated. And so he had another day of school yesterday. So hopefully he'll be a little bit better today.
Speaking of class, your team GPA is real high. Just how much does that mean to you?
Well, a lot. I mean, you know, a lot of fans could care less because they just want to win, you know, and I get it. And then there's another group of fans that care that we have all the components of the program moving in the right direction. And academics is right in line with, you know, social, the citizenship there, and their play on the floor, you know. And, you know, I've always said that you've got to have four complete units here, components, silos that activate mutually exclusive of each other, but they all have to exist to have a complete program. And it's academics, it's their citizenship, it's winning games, and it's also here in Vegas, it's your style of play. It's running. I think that's a fourth dynamic here that doesn't exist everywhere. So, but all those things need to be in place to really, I think, have a successful program. So it's good to know that silo is intact and strong and holding its own.
And you get Brandon, you get a lot of guys who can consider one and done, the stereotypes, they don't care about school, but he obviously cares about school. Is that, How important was that him do so well that last semester?
I think though Brandon's whole anytime you recruit an elite athlete or an athlete that has the accolades of McDonald's All-American and USA, you know, player and those kinds of things, you got to make sure that they fit who you are as a coach and your system and your philosophical paradigm that exists. And he checked all those boxes, so that's why it was appealing because of who he is as a person.
When you recruit players, how important is it to, because you mentioned character a lot in recruiting. Yeah. It's
kind of important.
Yeah, what is that? Where do academics fall when it comes to, I mean, how closely, I mean, where on the list, I guess, is that when you're recruiting players, how important is that to you?
Well, I think it's important because usually, I mean, if you think about it, if a kid's a good student, there's usually some other things that go in line with that, right? And so I think as you look forward to growing a program from where we took over to where we are now, we've got to make sure all the guys have certain things. They've got to place some value in certain areas that I place value in so that we're in one accord as we move the foundation forward and grow the program. And so that's, I wouldn't put a hierarchy on it because I think all of those boxes need to be checked. And that's just one of the boxes. Anything else, guys?
Thanks, Mark.
Brandon, what do you, a game like that against San Jose, you know, you guys have to grind it out to win it. Just give us the overall theme, I guess, of what you take away from that. Is that a wake-up call? Does that bring you guys closer together, a win like that? Or what does that kind of say about you?
Honestly, a win is a win. I feel like we got better. You know, San Jose is better than what we expected. And, you know, we came out there and we just competed and they competed hard. I think they shot the best they ever shot at playing against us. So, you know, we just got to learn that in this conference, we're going to get everybody's best shot and we just got to come out and compete.
And a win's a win. Yeah. Just the mindset of the team moving forward, Utah State next, Just moving forward.
Just getting in the gym, getting some free throws up. Unfortunately, I wasn't in there because I'm a little under the weather. But, you know, just keep standing in the gym and just working on our craft and just listening to the coach's plan.
What do you think has been the biggest issue, defensive rebounding the last couple of games?
I don't think it's been really a big issue. Coach has been telling everyone to crash the glass, so, you know, everyone was starting to crash the glass. At first, it was just me and Shakur, but, you know, I think Chris had like 7 rebounds yesterday. We out rebounded San Jose yesterday by over four, and, you know, they're the number 18 rebounding team in the country, so I feel like we did pretty good on defensive rebounding.
Talk about Tramell Beck's off the bench, just how efficient he's been. I think he had 9 points in 10 minutes in San Jose State's game.
Nuno, we call him Nuno. He's a very talented player. He's like the life of the team. He's a jokester, and you know we just love when he comes in because he plays so hard and gives us so much.
We're about halfway through the season now. How do you feel you've performed offensively so far? How do you feel you've been integrated into the offense? You feel like you're comfortable now, 100%, you know, locked in?
Right now, I'm just focusing on my team. I feel like, you know, I'm just trying to do everything to help us win, you know, whether that be defensively or offensively, just trying to get better.
How do you feel you played on defense to this point?
I'm learning, in high school, I didn't have to guard such good bigs and stuff, so I'm still learning the game and, you know, just trying to get better every day.
What's been the hardest part about, you know, adjusting to that defensive end?
Nothing's really been hard, you know, it's just locking in and just getting better, listening to Coach Jeter, what he has to tell me, and just, you know, playing hard.
What have they been, you know, coaching you on defensively, and what do they want to see out of you?
Just that I give it my all, just play as hard as I can, and when I'm tired, just get out.
What did you think of the way Mbaka Jiang played the other night against San Jose State? He had a big game.
Oh, I gave him the highest praise because he the one who kept us in the game with that one free throw. And, you know, he had a couple game-saving blocks and just a game-saving rebound. So, you know, Ibaka is a great player. And he's still, you know, he's like 17 or 18, so he's still learning the game. And, you know, playing against him and Jake is an honor.
Now, Coach Menzies, he said that he was going offense, defense with you guys late in the game, substitutions. Yeah. Does that bother you at all? Do you take that? Do you want to be out there for those defensive possessions?
I wasn't really bothered because I had 4 fouls and, you know, I understood that, you know, the game was more important than myself and what I wanted. So, as long as we won, I didn't care.
You feel confident in yourself that you can play with 4 fouls and not foul out of a game?
Yeah, I feel like it, but, you know, he felt otherwise, and, you know, I don't blame him for it because, you know, we want to win. And that's, like I said, I don't worry about myself when it comes to my team. I put my team before me any other day.
Brandon,
Fork, you tweeted last weekend 3.34 GPA.
This is a really big deal, you know, to make my mom smile. She always wanted me to get like a 4.0, though, so, you know, as always, you know, I got to get better at everything. And I'm just happy. I didn't know that, you know, I thought college was going to be way harder, but, you know, I got a good support system and, you know, kind of helps us a lot off the court with schoolwork, and I thank him for that.
Have you always been good at school?
I've been pretty good. You know, I graduated with like a 3.5. So, I mean, school has come pretty easy.
And this team GPA is pretty high. Is it initially the support system? Is that something that Coach Menzies emphasizes pretty
often? Yes. Coach Jeter, it's really Coach Jeter who stays on our head and stuff about it. You know, and Connor's a great, great academic advisor. And, you know, without him, I don't think most of us would have over a 3.0.
You got a favorite class or something that you sort of look forward to on the student side?
First semester, I was looking forward to this year rock and roll because it was talking about music. And, you know, I love music and stuff, so, yeah.
What was your hardest class this last semester?
My hardest class, I had to say, was urban studies. I had like a 10 or 12 page paper to do, and I never wrote that many pages in my life.
Sure. Welcome to our life.
That's crazy.
You have any classes with teammates or anything that you sort of you guys can work on, team up together?
I had a nursing class with Anthony as well as Ben, and I had a UIST class with Ben as well. And then I had History of Rock and Roll with Anthony and Amari, so we used to work together a lot.
Cool. Thanks,
Brandon.
Thanks, Brandon. How do you feel?